Hi there, welcome back. Dan again from Clean Guru. So today may go just a minute or two longer because I'm going to be sharing some personal things about our family life to try to make a point about the cleaning business. And I think I'm going to title this, What You're Going to Need to Do in Order to Be Successful in the Cleaning Business. The story is this. My wife and I have a little dog named Daisy. She's kind of a mutt, but has some beagle in her. And about 9 years ago, I remember doing a little video where I actually kind of held her up here, and she was brand new. I think she was just a few months old. Anyway, here we are. Fast forward, I think 8, 9 years later, she's been great. But what's happened is our lives have changed. My dad just died recently. He was almost 96, and just a few months ago. And my mom is still hanging in there, doing the best she can, doing all right, really. And she'll be 98 in a couple months. My wife's parents, Jennifer, her parents are 89 and I think it's 93. So we have these parents that are now almost 98, 93 and 89. And in addition to that, we've been lucky. We have a new grandson and we have another grandchild on the way. As a result, Jennifer's doing some babysitting. Okay, enough of all that. Why do I tell you that? Because we're not home as much. And with my father, and I think that's gonna happen with my other parents too, as they get to be even older, is there's a lot of times you end up in the hospital or somewhere to try to take care of them, to help them. So we're away from the house a lot. And now with babysitting, Jennifer's away from the house a lot. This has been miserable. We don't like the fact that Daisy, our dog, has no one around. So we have tried now to try to find her a good home, someone that will love her and take care of her. And she's just a great dog, well behaved, great with kids, just terrific. But twice now we've had something happen, kind of embarrassing, but we actually found her a home with someone, they took them in, one person had them for I think a month or two or so, and then said their life got too complicated, actually called us back, said would we take her back? I know as crazy as that seems, we did, because we love this dog. We brought her back into our home. Here we are, another year goes by, said, boy, we really gotta find her a new home. We've gotta find Daisy a place. We thought we found someone. They had her about 2 days, and they seemed really terrific. They called and said, I think she's just a little too much energy for us, which I didn't really notice that with her, but they thought that. Well, we didn't just leave her there. We went and picked Daisy back up again. She's back with us. Jennifer, my wife, could not believe it. She was devastated. She said, this is crazy. I can't believe this. This is ridiculous. How could this possibly happen? And I submit that you know how this happened. If you run a cleaning business, you know that you can be disappointed time and time again by customers, employees, man, anyone, even yourself. And all of a sudden something happens and you go, there's no way this can happen again, and it happens again. And you feel like giving up. Say there's an employee you're counting on, and another employee you hire, and they let you down, they quit, and another person quits, and you might think this is ridiculous, it cannot work. If you want to be a successful cleaning business owner, which you probably are getting to be there now or already are, you know that you need to do two things. You need to face the truth that those kinds of things happen. Three things maybe. Stick with it, to not give up on fixing that, and maybe come up with some creative ways to handle it. Why do I tell you that? Because it's the same thing with our dog Daisy. We're not giving up on her. We understand that these things happen. It just happens. Secondly, we're not going to give up on finding her a new home. We're going to find her a new loving home. But third, we may come up with some creative ways. The vet said, well, you can put up a sign here. We can do this and that. We may have to change our strategy a little. This accepting that crazy things can happen and it keeps pushing you down, like maybe employee surprises that disappoint you when it happens time and time again. But if you're going to be successful in cleaning, you know you've got to learn to not give up. And on top of that, maybe sprinkle in some new creative ways to help fix the problem. We're certainly going to try that with Daisy. Until next time, remember, you can do this. You really can.